Let's get straight to the point. Which is better in 2024? Camera, such as by Canon 5D, or even an entry-level DSLR or mirrorless, or our trusty iPhones. The chart showcases the dramatic shift in the photography landscape. Over the past 70 years, we had film cameras declining, then we had digital cameras emerge, but both paled as iPhones and other smartphones came in around 2007, and the rest is history. So if you are considering buying an entry-level camera, you need to understand that the lens is just as important, if not more important, than the actual camera. You can get away with a pretty average body without all the whiz-bang knobs and dials, as long as you've got a decent lens. It's the lens that gives you the quality and the sharpness on your images. Another area where iPhones, I think, are at a bit of a disadvantage is in bright lights or looking directly into the sun and things like that. You can get some very creative effects with lens flare, but you get some weird effects as well. Very unusual colour sort of ripples across some of the pictures, whereas you won't get that with a dedicated camera. Dynamic range, and for those of you that don't know what that's your ability to have much greater detail in the shadow and much better highlights in the highlights. And it's a lot more detailed and a lot more information across the board. So you can see a lot more on your iPhone. However, it's also an issue at times because the software can, it's a very enhanced sort of look of HDR effect, like a high dynamic range effect, which is what HDR stands for. And it can make skin tone specifically look very plastic and fake looking. And there's no way to turn that software feature off. So yes, you will have better perceived dynamic range on the iPhone, but it will look a lot more fake and less natural than the camera can do. Similarly with natural colours, both of the iPhone and Canon offer good natural looking colours, and the Canon R10, the entry level camera, offers a wider variety of colour profiles, which can provide more colour information when you get into editing later. The iPhone does offer a 10-bit colour depth option, but only when shooting in ProRes, which creates very large files and will use up your phone's memory very, very quickly. Overall colour, the iPhone colours can look better straight out of the camera compared to the Canon R10 or my 5D, but I'm shooting raw. As far as I'm concerned, what comes out of your camera is like a negative in the olden days when I used to do film. You have to process it and print the photo. It's the same as editing in Lightroom. The other thing with the R10 is HDR shooting will disable your digital image stabilization, so you will need a tripod. In short, the iPhone has easier colours and better colours, good looking right away straight out of the camera, but the DSLRs or mirrorless, you've got a lot more option in editing the colours with way better, potentially better results. Generally, smartphones tend to be very good at autofocus because they have very small sensors and everything's typically in focus anyway. They're also very good for tracking moving subjects, but for landscape photography or outdoor photography, this isn't an issue. Mirrorless cameras also have autofocus, but again, it can be more complex and may require the user to select a specific focus point. Some mirrorless cameras struggle with autofocus in low light conditions, but there are things you can do to minimize that effect. Obviously, one of the things that I prefer more about a camera to an iPhone is the ability to have creative control. You can use manual mode, or when you're starting out, you can use some of the auto modes. And things like bokeh or your background blue, that's lens dependent, things like that, which is a little bit more involved and deeper, but you don't have that. You have a slight ability with that in some of the settings in the iPhones, but overall the camera will definitely shine there, and your auto modes are going to be far more reliable. Battery life is another issue depending on your phone and how much you use it. Mine doesn't last that long and I'm always looking to charge it during the day, but with my Canon camera I have half a dozen batteries and they're always charged, especially if I'm going out on a big shoot. The cold saps both the iPhone's batteries and the Canon batteries, so you always need to have spares or a backup for your phone if you're shooting in snow or really cold conditions, because it does use up your batteries much, much quicker in that sort of weather. My final thoughts on what's better, a camera, dedicated camera, or an iPhone, really comes down to what your intentions are and what your budget is. You can these days purchase an entry-level camera with a decent lens for under what it cost you to buy one of the new Apple iPhones. There's many savvy ways about how to go purchasing gear that isn't new but is going to be absolutely awesome for what your landscape photography is and where you're going with that. At the end of the day, it's all about what you want to do, how much you want to spend, how much time you want to put into this. There are skills that you're going to have to learn. I started off in the film days and I had to learn how to work in the darkroom. So many, many hours were spent among trays of chemicals and printing actual photos. But these days it's much, much easier. We don't have to spend money on all of that. And we can delete on our cameras. So it's much, much easier to learn and far, far quicker to get those skills.
One area where phones lead the way is in the easy ability to change lens options with a simple click of a button. The iPhone telephoto offers a 77mm and then you have a 48mm equivalent, which is your everyday shooting option. Then you have a 24mm equivalent, which is a 2x zoom of the 48mm. Or a digital zoom. Finally, you have a 13mm equivalent in the wide angle lens.
If you're anything like me and you start out, you will get hooked. I've been a full-time photographer for over 30 years now, even right back to the darkroom days. I'm not about to give up anytime soon, and I'd love to help you achieve some of the things that I've achieved over my time. It's all about the journey on the way, and I'd love to help you on yours. The other thing that's really important is as you get older, I find using my iPhone quite difficult. I find the buttons very small, my eyes are getting worse, I have to use glasses.
The one thing that DSLRs offer is an ergonomic variance compared to smartphones. Their solid build and dedicated buttons provide a tactile feel that a phone can't deliver. Imagine being able to adjust settings without even taking your eye off the viewfinder. Plus, the optical viewfinder is perfect for composing shots on sunny days or when your phone battery is low. And of course, they're not perfect. They can be bulky compared to phones, but for those who prioritize control, feel, and a dedicated shooting experience, a DSLR camera might be the perfect fit, just like it is for me.